again the same mode of attendance we would be take today from the chat window. I would be informed you when I would be activate the chat window for 5 minutes only. Okay. In the last lecture, I have introduced the convolutional codes, and we have learned the convolutional codes in detail, and we have also encoded one message of 3-bit 101 and we have generated the code word for that particular message. So I want to ask you that, are you comfortable with this description, or you have means you are able to generate the code word from the convolutional encoder, or I have to repeat that particular topic? Everyone comfortable with the convolutional coding that we have learned in the last lecture? We have defined the convolutional codes, then we have seen the 1/2 rate convolutional coding, we have defined the shift registers, and as well as we have also taken one example of message sequence 101, and then we have finally generated the code word, that is 11100011, and also shown the effect, also seen the effect of the this coding, how the code rate would be decreased when you have added the flush bits at the end of the message, and that is the effective code rate. Up to this point we have discussed in the last lecture. So just I want to take your feedback, are you comfortable with this? So we would be proceed further topics, the another methods of the convolutional encoding.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Who is saying?
Repeat your answer. Hello.
Who is talking?
Please tell your name. Nankade, sir.
Nankade. Okay. Nankade wants to repeat the coding. Those who have not attended the lecture, maybe for them it is a little bit difficult, because convolutional encoding having the certain steps. First of all, I have gone through the way of direct coding methods with the help of the shift register. After that, we have to be learn about the another coding methods like connection vectors or polynomial vectors. Then the similar code word could be generated with the help of a state diagram, then tree diagram, and finally the tree list diagram. These are the some methods are remaining: tree diagram, tree list diagram, state diagram, and polynomial representation. We have just used the connection pictorial method for generating the code word. And after that, there is another topic is the decoding method of convolutional code. For that, we have to use the Viterbi algorithm. So that would be also take the one of the lecture, and trellis and tree would be take one of the lecture. So if you are not comfortable, so it is very important to go through one by one. Again, I am repeating this topic today for you. Only I would be repeat the method that we have to be follow when we are doing the convolutional codes. Okay. So already we have seen that. It is a convolutional code is a method, an approach to error control coding, and that is different from the block coding that we have already learned. In the block coding, what we do, we have to be segment a data stream into the fixed size blocks, but in the convolutional codes we would be encode the entire data stream into a single code word. This is the fundamental difference. In the block codes we use the algebraic technique or combinatorial techniques, but in the case of convolutional codes we use the construction technique. So if you have to be see the representation of convolutional codes. So this is the representation of the convolutional codes where you can see it would be represented as n comma small k comma capital K. This is n, where n is what? Number of bits in the code word. K is what? It is the number of bits in the message. Okay, so at a time we would be use one bit. That's why in today's example we would be take k is equal to 1. Okay, then capital K is what? It is called the constant length of the encoder. So how many shift register basically we are using here? So this is called the constant length. Okay, and k minus 1 is what? It would be represent the memory element. Okay, of conventional encoder. So the number of memory element would be always less than the constant length by 1. So k minus 1. Suppose k is 3, so number of memory element is 2. Okay, that would be store the data. And another way of representation of convolutional code is by k by n, means it is your RC actually, coding rate comma constant length. This is another way of representation, either this way or this way. Okay, so RC is what? Coding rate, number of bits in the message upon number of bits in the code word, that determines the number of data bits per coded bit. Okay, so this is the basic information we have to be required, means code rate and constant length, for constructing the code word with the help of convolutional encoder. In the questions also it is mentioned that this much is the code rate and this is the constant length. You have to be generate the all code words possible from the given information for the using the convolutional encoder. Okay, so see here, I am just skipping this block diagram and digital communication system. Now we have to be design or we have to take an example, that is 1/2. Coding rate is what? 1/2, and constant length is k is equal to 3. And by using this information of convolutional encoder, we would be generate the code word. So as per it is mentioned here, constant length is what? It is 3. So how many shift register we would use? You use the 3 shift registers. Okay, and out of this 3 shift register, this is the 3 shift registers are there. So this shift register would be representing the constant length. And how many memory elements out of these 3 shift registers? 2, k minus 1. Okay, so here you can see the first one takes incoming data bit. So I have already told you that convolutional encoder, we would be take a stream of data to generate the code word. We do not subdivide it as in the fixed size blocks. We would take a stream of data. But at a time, one bit of data would be entered to the shift register. So this first shift register would be here to take the incoming message bits, one bit at a time. And rest of two would be used as a memory element of this encoder. And this two, this is the modulo 2 addition, modulo 2 addition symbol. There is also modulo 2 addition. Okay, so this is nothing but a representation of generating vectors. You can consider a G1 and G2 maybe. These are the generating vectors. So what is the generating vectors? It is a combination of shift registers, possibility of shift registers. And this generating vector, along with this, the information present in the shift register would be responsible for generation of output or branch word, you can say. It is a branch word we were to be generated, or code word you have to generate. You can see here, this is a, as per the coding rate, n is equal to 2. So there is a 2 output bit possible, U1 and U2. So when you have to write U1, then call U2, this is your output coded bit. this is representation of n. Okay, so here the for 2 bit output code word we have to use the 2 modulo 2 adders. If it is 3 bit, so we have to use the 3 modulo bit adders like this. So upper modulo 2 adder would be responsible for the first coded bit, and lower would be responsible for the second coded bit. So if you want to understood this topic, you have to be ready with pen and notebook, and you have to be noted down this diagram, because on the basis of this diagram we would be going to generate the code word. Okay, so if you have to be see here, so what we are actually doing, we are generating the code word with the help of shift register and modulo 2 adders and the incoming message bits. So whatever the combination of this shift register by G1 in addition with this message bit, this would be interlaced with the combination of G2 with available bits in the shift register. So when both would be interlaced, interlacing has been done with this of the switch, you would be able to generate output coded bits, that is U1 comma U2. Okay, now we have to be see this example in detail by taking one of the example. So what example we are taking here, if you have to see, same shift register module would be drawn 6 times. If you want to generate all the code words, you have to draw this module up to 6 times. Why we have to do this? Because we are taking a 3 bit data as a message sequence. So it is a 101. Okay, so number of bits present in the message is represented as a L, capital L. Okay, so we have know that already that there is a constant length is 3. 3 shift registers are there, and also we have taken a message for our example is a 3 bit message. Okay, so to flush out completely this present message on the arrival of the next message, we have to be required some flush bits, and for that purpose we would be use the flush bits here to flush out all the information from this shift register. So the number of flush bits could be what? The formula for deciding the number of flush bits is capital K minus 1, means constant length minus 1. So here the number of flush bits would be 2. So along with this message of sequence 101, we have to use the 2 flush bits, and generally we use zeros as a flush bits. This is your flush bits that is used to flushing out this information from the shift register on the arrival of the next stream of message. Okay, why we have to be required the flushing out? If you would be not flush it out, then what happens when the next stream of the message would be come and enter to this shift register, this would be create a confusion, or maybe it would be generate some errors on the generated code word. So it is a basic condition that before encoding any message stream, we have to be make all the positions of the shift register 000, all zero position. We have to start always with the all zero condition. Then and then only we would be able to generate the error free encoded code word. Okay, so we start the coding. First timestamp T1, we have to be take it as, so initially all bits are zero. Now because of the first T1, what happens, the first bit 1 would be come here, first bit 1 would be come here. Okay, so what is the first bit is my 1, and remaining 2 positions of the shift register or memory element you can say it is 00. So what happens, because of entering this one here, the generating vector would be generate code word u1 and u2. So it is 1 plus 0 plus 0, u1 is what? 1. Fit z2, 1 plus 0, it is 1. Means odd number of ones in g1 also and g2 also, that means your output would be 1 1. Okay, so this is your first coded output or first branch combination of first branch word with first bit of the message. After time t1, at the another timing instant t2, what happens? The next bit 1 is already here in the previous t1, and this 1 is now shifted to next shift register because of the we have advanced the time by the one time instant t2. And now the second code, second bit of this message would be entered to the first shift register, first block of the shift register, and this zero, rightmost zero, would be flush out, and the second zero would be come to the third position. So in this way, shifting of this bits value would be there. Now, as we know that G1 is combination of all these three blocks and G2 is only two blocks. So what happens? It would be 0 plus 1 plus 0, U1 is 1, but 0 plus 0, it is U2 is 0. So then your output is 1 0 for the time instant T2. So once you have understood how this shifting and generation of output branch word is there, for one or two time instant you can easily generate for the other time instant. So see here, at time t3 what happens for our message. So this 1 is now at the rightmost position, and this 0 is now again shifted for the next time interval, is in the middle position. Now the remaining is only this 1. So this 1 would be entered to the leftmost position of the shift register, and here the possible combinations are there for G1 and G2. So here U1 is what? 1 plus 0 plus 1. Here the even number of ones means output is 0. Again for G2, 1 plus 1. Again even number of ones means output is 0. So output would be 0 0 for the third time instant. Okay. So now you can see for 1 0 1. So for 1 it is code word is 1 1, for 0 it is code word 1 0, for 1 again it is code word 0 0. Okay, we have generated up to this point, and this is for t1 time instant, t2, and this is t3 time instant. Now the t4 time instant, what happens? All these three messages now entered here. So first one is now, when the next incoming with T4 time, this is the time when you have to be enter the first flush bit 0. Okay, so at that moment what happens? The first one is flushed out because we have used the first flush bit, so it would be flushed out of this box shift register. Second bit would be enter now reach to the rightmost position, and last one is enter into the middle position, and our first flush bit is entering here at the leftmost position. So because of that, what happens? Our combination would be now changed. So for U1 it is 0 plus 1 plus 0 1, for U2 it is 0 plus 0 0. So for the fourth time instant, incoming bit is 0 as a flush bit. This is your flush bit, first flush bit. So your output would be 1 0. So now we have generated up to this point for the time instant t4. I hope you have understand this. I am going very slowly. Till anyone has any doubt, please ask. This is very important coding technique. And very frequently asked in the examination. Okay. Now, come to the another point. At a time instant, T5. And you can take it as a, suppose, 5th second. 1st, 2nd, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, this is a 5, in that 5 second, time interval of the 5 second, it would be the 5th time instant. That T5 instantaneous value is what? Of here, leftmost. Now we know that already 1 is discarded at T4. Now 0 would be discarded at T5 time. So you can see here, 0 is not present here. 0 is already discarded. Okay. Or flushed out, you can say. Only this 1 would be present at the last or rightmost position. And we have added the first plus bit that would be available to the middle position. Now at a time instant T5, we would be enter the second plus bit. So what happens? This would be available at the leftmost position. Now the combination is what? G1 and G2 you can see. So U1 is what? 0 plus 0 plus 1. 0 plus 0 plus 1. Then what is this? U1 is what? Odd number of 1, so 1. U2 is again 0 plus 1, odd number of 1, 1. So at time, you can see it is for 1, it is for 0, it is for 1, it is for 0, T1 time instant, T2, T3, T4, and this is your T5. The second flush bit is there, output is 1, 1. Now you can see here, at the at a time instant T5, only 1 bit is present of message. Only 1 element is present of the message, and rest of the 2 are flush bits. So what happens now at time T6? Your convolutional encoder is ready to take the upcoming or next message. It is ready or it is prepared for receiving the next message or new message. Because what happens when you have to advance T5 by 1 second, or you have to go to enter your T6, this 1 would be flushed out. So remaining 2 position is the our flush bits, means 0, 0, and we know that always we have to start with the 0, 0, and because of that there will be also a vacancy in this leftmost condition. Or you can, maybe at time T instant T6, there is a new message would be entered, or maybe it would be wait for 1 or 2 or time instant T6, T7, then it would be entered the new message. So it would be by default, it would be 0 till new message is not coming. So at time instant T6, basically it is used for reader to verify that the flushing bit is completed. Flushing is completed at time instant T5. So the new message can be entered at time T6. That's why we have not taken the output generated at T6 for our message. Okay. We have only taken this up to T5. So do not confuse with the diagram T6. You have to be sure this diagram, and you have to be take a note, or you have to be give a remark that T6 is basically used to user to verify that flushing is completed at T5. And the new, it is your shift register is ready for the, or your encoder is ready for the new upcoming message at T timestamp T6. Okay. Now, This is the way that we have to be do the encoding with the help of the convolutional encoder by using the connecting pictorials. Now tell me, I hope that all of you have understood the concept. I am repeating this repeated this topic from the previous lecture. Anyone has still any doubt, please ask me. Or any point you have found difficult to understand. Please, anyone? Turn on your mic and give me the reply. I'm also enabling the attendance for you, and this is only activated for 5 minutes. Okay, so till you are entering your attendance also, please, anyone has any doubt, you can ask me. No one has no doubt because no one is asking anything. Okay. So, yeah. Okay, who want to speak? So, okay, give me the reply that have you understood this topic? How to do the encoding?
Yes,
now it is clear. It is a matter of practice only. It is a very simple way using the pictorial connections. We have to be generate the code word. Just do one of the another example. Take one of the another example, and do this encoding. Okay. I have taken 101. You have to take another any value 111 or maybe 4-bit. It if you would be at the 4-bit, so number of time instant would be increased. Okay. So this is the method to encode the convolution using the convolutional encoder. You have to encode any message sequence. Now I have also told you that because of this method, effective code rate has been decreased. Initially, we have taken a example that by taking a code rate of 1/2, but because of addition of this flushing bits to the original message or incoming message, because of adding this flushing bit, what happens? Your coding rate would be decreased. So the new formula for effective coding rate is what? R effective is equal to capital L upon N into L upon small k plus capital K minus 1. And that would be R effective is always less than RC. So what is L is here? Number of data bits present in the message sequence. So we have taken a 3-bit message. Okay. And N is 2, 3 upon, and small k is what? 1. Plus 3 minus 1. So what happens? 3 upon 2 into 3 upon 1 is 3. Plus 6, 5. So it would be 3 upon 10. So you can see R effective is 0.3. And RC is what? 1 upon 2. That is 0.5. So you can easily compare here. Effective code rate is less than the actual code rate. And why the code rate is decreased? Because we have added the flush bit at the end of the message. Okay. Now, we have to see the vector representation of the convolutional encoder. So if you have to see here, we have defined the n binary vectors. for our convolutional encoding with the k elements. K means constant length here, capital K. So what happens? One vector for each modulo 2 adder. So we have defined n binary vector with k elements means one vector for each modulo 2 adder. So we have to be see here. There is a, we have the n value is 2. So here the two vector u1 and u2. And one vector for each modulo 2 adder. Each modulo 2 adder we have the one for g1, u1 and for g2, u2. If ith element in each of the vector is 1, then if ith element of each vector is 1, at what condition? If ith stage in the shift register is connected to the corresponding modulo 2 adder. And ith element is 0, at which condition? 0 in a given position indicate that no connection exists between the stage and the modulo 2 adder. Okay, so you can see here the generating vectors are there, g1 and g2, two vectors we are using as two modulo 2 adder. G1 is what? It is a condition when all the stages are connected to modulo 2 adder, all three stages, that's why it is 1 1 1. And g2 is a condition what? When only two stages are connected. Which two stages are connected here? First and last. Means it is 1, 0, 1. So it is mentioned here. One it would be happen when all the stages would be connected to modulo 2 adder. And 0 when it is not, any stage is missing or it is not connected to modulo 2 adder. So in this way you can define the connecting vectors also or connection vectors also as per the connection provided in the encoder structure. Okay, this is another way of representation. So on the basis of this baseline, we would be use the polynomial representation of the convolutional encoder. Okay, so what is here? We define n generator polynomial, one for each modulo 2 adder, and each polynomial of degree, this is very important. What is the degree of each polynomial? The each polynomial having the degree of k minus 1, capital K minus 1. That means constant length minus 1 or less than this. Maximum value could be K minus 1 or maybe it is less than this, the degree of polynomial. And describe it, this degree, each polynomial is describes the connection of shift register to the corresponding modulo 2 adders. So for example, we have the two connection vectors G1 and G2. So for G1x, in the polynomial term, we have to G1x, it is G0, because G1 is what? G1 is 1, 1, 1. We have already seen. So G0 plus G1x plus G2x square, because maximum degree is k minus 1. And here k is 3, so k minus 1 is 2. So it would be come as G0 plus G1x plus G2x, means we have to be take the coefficient of this. It is coefficient is 1, its coefficient is 1, or x actually, we can say coefficient is x, and its coefficient is x square. So it is 1 plus x square. Similarly for the g2, g2 is what? 1, 0, 1. So it is g0 plus g1x plus g2x square. But the coefficient is what? g0 is 1, okay. And in the middle, this is 0. X is actually 0 here. So it is 1 plus 0 plus x square. But we have to be write it as 1 plus x square. So the polynomial for g1 is 1 plus x square. And for polynomial for g2 is 1 plus x square. So what is the output? Output is what? It is representation of interlacing of mx gx or mx g1x with mx g2x. So what is mx is here? For our example, mx is what? It is 101, no? So it is mx is what? 1 plus x square. In our example, message is 1 plus x square. So ux would be obtained when mx multiply with the g1x interlaced with, in switching, there is switch is connected, mx into g2x. So you would be able to generate the ux. So here you can see how to generate the u of x, and from u of x we have to be retrieve the u. So mx gx is what? This is the first case for upper vector. If you remember the diagram, the upper vector is this. So message is 1 plus x square and g1x is 1 plus x square. The resultant would be 1 plus x cube plus x to the power 4. Similarly, the second lower vector is what? Mx plus g2x. So 1 plus x square plus 1 plus x square means 1 plus x to the power 4. And we have done the modulo 2 addition, okay? Do not confuse with this ki 1 plus x square whole square is 1 plus x square how? You can do this multiplication and apply the modulo 2 addition. You would find this. Now, we have to write the coefficient. So for mx, g1x is what? 1 plus x, x2, x square, the coefficient of x square is 0 here because it is not mentioned here. Then again x cube plus x to the power 4. Similarly to the other end, mx, g2x, 1, x to the coefficient is 0 because it is not x is mentioned. X square coefficient is again 0. X cube coefficient is again 0. Only the x4 having the coefficient is 1. Now apply the modulo 2 addition. So what is ux? 1 comma 1 first. It is 1 comma 0. Then 0 comma 0 x square. 0 comma, sorry, 1 comma 0 x cube. 1 comma 1 x to the power 4. In this way, whatever the coefficient of x, you can consider this is the x to the power 0. So coefficient of x would be give you the value of resultant code word. So the code word is what? 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1. And this is for message 1 0 1. So you can compare this method output u with this previous method of pictorial connection. You would be found that for the same message stream, output is same, code word is same. So either of the two method you can use. And it is simple for the simple message. It is having, we have having the 3-bit message, it is simple. But when the number of bits would be increases, it would be complicated. So this was the second method. Okay, for the next lecture, I think your time is very less now. In the next lecture, tomorrow we would be learn state diagram, tree diagram and trellis diagram. Remaining three methods of convolutional encoder.